you might think that you're doing somebody some good by protecting Gabe, but believe me, he doesn't need any protection. Hello friends, my name is Brandon Dayton, I am your humble narrator, and welcome to Paranautical Activity. This is a game that I dug up out of my Steam library, however it's no longer on the Steam store, and the reason for that is the dev threatened Gabe Newell's life. If you don't know, Gabe Newell is the founder of Steam, and he has pulled Paranautical Activity from the store. It can still be found in your library if you had it, but it is gone forever from the store. Basically what happened is this game came out of early access in early October, and this entire month, apparently the dev has been trying to get Gabe himself to remove the early access banner from their store page. It is now October 21st, and the dev last night said on Twitter, I will kill Gabe Newell. It's not really that funny because I love Steam and I love Gabe, but man, fucking the spurging out on the internet is just crazy. I understand that it's an open platform, as it should be, and that you can say whatever you want. However, you need to be able to defend the things that you say. The First Amendment will only take it so far, and that is what the dev has been screaming out. Ah, First Amendment! It's part of my rights, and blah blah blah. And I posted to the dev that said this last night, and I said, having a game on Steam is not a constitutional right. He didn't respond or anything, but I thought I made a good point. So maybe that's why I'm making this video. I mean, the game is good. You know, I feel bad for the other people on the team who were involved. I was talking to the coder as well, and, you know, he's a good guy. He's got a family to feed. He seems regular. And he was just involved with some stupid people, which is unfortunate. And his career will probably take a hit because of it. I just really can't stand the culture that we've cultivated. If you could even call it a culture, it's more like a big homogenous mass that the entire world's lumped into. And really, it's just sad. Nobody has an identity, so they want to make an identity out of shitting on other people's lives. You know, what happened between the dev and Gabe, or it was between the dev and Gabe, you know what I mean? The entire internet doesn't really need to blow up about it, but unfortunately that's the case. Everybody wants to pick sides. I'm in the middle. I believe if the dev said, I hope someone kills Gabe Newell, a la Ted Nugent. He said, I hope somebody kills the president. And that was defended by the First Amendment, because it wasn't a direct threat. So while I think it's dangerous to pick straws, I think, you know, a point needs to be made. Kind of like the Duck Dynasty boys on A&E, they said, God doesn't like gays, and A&E was like, well, we're basically made of gays, so you gotta go. But the, you know, the viewers reached out and they said, no, this is perfectly fine for them to have an opinion. And while what he's saying was not an opinion, it was a statement of fact and a threat, I believe if he had worded it slightly differently, it would be defensible. The heat of the moment is a thing that you can only really call upon in real life. If you're in an argument with somebody and you say something stupid, then you go, look, man, I shouldn't have said that. But if you're on a social media platform and you have time to actively think about whatever you're typing or uploading, you need to. I understand that the internet is this open platform, but people need to be able to defend the things that they say. And really, with, you know, anonymity on the internet, most people don't have to, which is great for the trolls, but for people like us who are trying to be nice or produce content or, you know, do anything there's always the naysayers. I do make it a point to try and be nice to everybody that I interact with online. Not only because you might be talking to a potential subscriber or fan, but because it's the right thing to do. And I think a lot of people forget that that's a thing, or don't care that that's a thing. And I think that's really sad. It reflects on our society. So I think it's important to point out that I think everybody is in the wrong here, basically, except for Gabe. Not just because I love Gabe and Steam, but basically because I'm sick of the culture we've created. The biggest baby gets the most milk, and it just all depends on how hard you can whine. That's what it's all come down to recently. And I'm extremely disappointed with our culture as a whole. The coder said that Steam was he said that Steam is a monopoly, which it completely isn't. There are plenty of other good distribution, well, good might be a stretch, but there are plenty of other distributions out there. You have Uplay from Ubisoft, you've got EA from, or Origin from EA, there's Desura, which is, I believe, standalone, I'm not sure who bumps that, and then you've got Glyph, which is Trion Worlds, and I had to download that for Trove. So currently I have five Steam-like programs on my computer, and, you know, if Paranautical Activity was in my library on another platform, I would probably still play it, because it is a fun game, and it's a pity that it was removed from the store just because of one person's stupid actions. I feel a little lost here. I think we're all lost. As a society, we're just lost. We're trying to cobble together this culture out of something that doesn't really exist. This is a cool bullet hell game. It's got a nice soundtrack. It's got fun gameplay. The enemies are pretty cool. It might be a little difficult to start with, but it's just a shame, you know? Some people can't control their tongue, and in return, other people want to control their lives. The person who can't control their tongue, that being. I don't know. I feel like that's all I really have to say about the incident. I don't really want to turn this into a gameplay thing, because that's not why I picked it up today, and that's not why I made this video. So, I hope you will join me for my next rant, depending what happens in the wide world of the internet. And until then, I've been Brandon Dayton, your humble narrator. This has been Paranautical Activity. See you next time. Bye-bye!
1, 2, 3, 4. Goodbye, goodbye, see you again. Goodbye, goodbye, see you, my friends.